Hey, my name is Marcus Butler, and today I'm here at Facebook HQ with Anti-Bullying Pro. So today I went to an event about a year ago in Ireland. I think it's a similar thing as this, where it's a showcase to support and, I guess, give awards to people to show the amazing things that they've been doing for the charity or for schools throughout Ireland. And then this is kind of the same thing as that, but in London. So it's going to be a similar thing. I'm going to be up here. I'm going to be hosting a panel. I'm also going to be handing out some awards and presenting some videos. So it should be a lot of fun. I think it's such a, in today's world, it's such a, like, bullying is such an issue, and it's so easy to jump on the bandwagon and bully someone. So the people that are standing up against those bullies, I feel like they should be supported, and, you know, they're doing amazing things to help people around the world. So I feel like it's only right to say, hey, you've done a great job. Yeah, so I was bullied at school for doing something that I loved doing, which was gymnastics. People used to make fun of me all the time, which led to me quitting something that I loved doing, and I did it for 10 years. So that for me was a regret, quitting that. So that's why I like to kind of tell people that if I had something like this back when I was younger, I maybe would not have quit because of that, because of those reasons for that. So it's all about showing positivity towards those people, that you don't have to stop doing something you love just because some people make fun of you for doing it. Honestly, my like best advice for people is talk to someone. Like, thinking about it, when I went through it, I didn't talk to anyone. I just went to my mum and was like, Mum, I want to quit gymnastics. And she was like, are you sure? Like, why do you want to do it? I was like, oh, I don't know, I just want to quit and I don't like it anymore and stuff like that. So the biggest thing I can say is just do talk to someone, whoever that is, whether it's a teacher, parent, friend, just tell someone. I feel like people get scared, or they think they're going to become a grass, if it's especially at school, and they'll get made more fun of for telling. But you've just got to, it's better to go about it in the right way than just let it continue and continue and continue, and then you might regret something for the rest of your life. I think when I went to Ireland last year, I went to go and visit a school, and there wasn't any story in particular that, you know, made me go, oh, like, or hit me really hard. It was just seeing how positive the school was in fighting bullying. So each individual kid, ranging from ages of like 11 all the way up to 16, how much of an impact they wanted to make on the school and how positive everyone was towards it. That for me, I was like, wow, like, I wish this was in my school when I was younger.
Lately, you've been on Masterchef. What was that experience like for you?
Yeah, Masterchef was amazing. It was such a, I felt massively out of my depth, and it was nowhere near as stressful as they made it seem. No, it was way more stressful than they made it seem on TV, but the whole thing was amazing fun.
I mean, how did that come about? What made you want to take part in a challenge like that?
I think for me, it was trying something new. I knew it would challenge me. I knew it would test me. And I just thought it would be a laugh, and the people who watch my videos would enjoy watching me on TV.
Were you surprised at all there was a little bit of negativity on particularly Twitter about the idea that you were a YouTube personality rather than someone that people knew off TV or from sport or something like that?
Yeah, no, because I've seen it with my friends. You're always going to get that when people don't understand YouTube or what a YouTuber is. So it didn't surprise me that there was negativity around it. If anything, I just found it funny, and it just continues the educational process of telling people what we do. It's such a hard thing, because it's like the bigger you get, the more of that stuff that comes. But for me, it was all about just realizing that no matter what you do, there's always going to be someone who's trying to bring you down. So if you just focus on the positive things, then leave the negative stuff away. You can block those people, you can delete those comments, you can get rid of them and just focus on the positives.
Your passion for music is something you've been really exploring lately. Can you talk us a little bit about that? Because it's a very exciting project for you.
Yeah, so you might have seen we announced that I've started a new company called Strip Bear, which is all about nurturing and growing and breaking brand new talented musicians' careers in a way that the traditional music industry doesn't do it. So I want to put the talent first. I want to put everything that comes with their career right for them first, and not try and rip them off or anything like this, and just help them as much as I can.
What's your ultimate ambition for that? What do you want to achieve with that?
I think I just want to shock the industry, you know, change how the music industry works, how talent management works in the music industry, and create this new form of digital media moving forwards in the music world.
If people want to get more information about that, or there's talented artists out there that would like to be involved, where can they go for that kind of information?
None of this has been released yet, so I can't say yet, but hopefully we're going to have a site up and running soon and we'll be able to like look at ways of doing things like that. But for now, it's just we've got the people that we're happy with, and we're just, you know, in a few months or however long it takes, they'll be announced to the world.
On YouTube, obviously, you're busy as always, and we've been loving some of the recent videos. What have you got coming up? Anything especially exciting?
There's nothing other than the usual stuff coming up right now. There's stuff planned for the future, but nothing set in stone, so I don't want to stand here and go, oh, I've got this, because I don't want to say things and then not stick to it.
So we've seen a lot of the other YouTubers branching out, particularly with big screen adventures. Is that something that you'd like to do at some point?
Again, possibly. There's nothing set in stone, but it's definitely looking at all my options and what I can do and also what I want to do right now. So for me, it's just about having fun and doing stuff that I really want to do.
YouTube's obviously about having fun, but the platform's definitely been evolving a lot, and there's been some issues with that. I think particularly with the Fine Brothers, the whole React sort of issue. Yeah. How did you feel seeing that as someone who is such a prominent part of the YouTube community and a brand in your own right?
Yeah, I just think it was like, you know, they're trying new things and what they wanted to do just didn't come out how they probably planned it to be, and you know, they realized they made a mistake, but everyone makes mistakes. YouTube allows you to make mistakes and then you can learn and move on with your career, which they have. I don't really have any fears with YouTube because I think it's the way forwards. It's growing, it's the biggest platform in the world. So for me, I have no fear with it. I just see, you know, it's going to be an amazing place to be part of in the future. I'd just like to say, if anyone's going through anything at home, or if you know someone who is going through something, then either tell someone if you're going through it, or if you know someone, just be there and talk to them. Let them open up to you, help them as much as you can, and hopefully things will turn out well.